Second John, the elder unto the elect lady and her children, whom I love in the truth, and not I only, but also all they that have known the truth, for the truth's sake which dwells in us and shall be with us forever. Grace be with you, mercy and peace from God the Father and from the Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of the Father, in truth and love. I rejoice greatly that I have found of thy children walking in truth, as we have received a commandment from the Father. Now I beseech thee, lady, not as though I wrote a new commandment unto thee, but that which we have from the beginning, that we love one another. And this is love, that we walk after his commandments. That this is the commandment, that as we have heard from the beginning, ye should walk in them. New verse. For many deceivers are entered into the world, who confess not that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh. This is a deceiver and an antichrist. Okay, we're up to number 29. 29 lessons in 2 John of the 7th verse. And a lot of information. Now, a lot of babies have been born in the world. Can't even count them all. From Cain and Abel being born to today, even right now, as we're speaking, there are babies being born. We have a hospital behind us. Babies are being born. A mother that gives birth has just populated heaven or hell. When a woman gives birth to a child, whether it be a male or a female, she has populated heaven or hell. She has given birth to a Christ rejecter or a born again Christian. She never gives birth to a purgatory child. That child that she gives birth to, whether if it would die within in the womb, stillborn, moments after birth, hours after birth, days after birth, weeks after birth, month after birth, years after birth, that child will be a resident of heaven or hell. He will be a Christ rejecter or a born again Christian. And then some of those Christians that will become Bible believing Christians will do nothing more with his life for Christ. And others that will be saved will become 30, 60, and 100 fold Christians. And some of you don't even know what I mean by 30, 60, and 100 fold Christians because you don't read your Bible. And the church that you are in won't teach you stuff like that. They'll teach you worldly philosophy and, you know, butterfly and love messages. There will be mothers that will produce men like David, Samuel, Paul, Peter, Obadiah Holmes, John Bunyan, and other men of God. And there will be mothers who will produce sons like Haman, Hitler, Judas, and deceivers. There are mothers out there of men that are in the pulpit today that went to a Bible cemetery and are deceiving people left and right. You watch that guy on the TV or on the radio, oh, that guy is so funny, and yet he had a mother. Even Adolf Hitler had a mother that would cradle him in her arms. If there is one thing, every child will grow up to be someone. So when we break down this book, someone became an elect lady. Someone became her children, and they served the Lord and did right. Someone was born who was named John, who had a brother named James, that would become the beloved disciple of Jesus Christ, and would write a letter or epistle to this lady that we have in our hands that we have been studying. And now we break into the letter. Now we touch where and why and what and how this letter, of all the things that we've learned, I said this is the 29th lesson. And we now break into the lesson of deceiver. For many deceivers are entered into the world. And the key word of this section, believe it or not, is Christ. Christ means anointed one. Jesus Christ is the Christ of God, the anointed one of God. The antichrist, who is a carbon copy of the Christ and exalts himself above God, is of Satan. You are either of God or you are of Satan. Either God is your father or Satan is your father. They confess not that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh. That person is a deceiver and an antichrist. So when you meet somebody who says, well, Jesus Christ, he's not God. He was some teacher. He was some angel. He was a brother of Lucifer. He's not really God. God didn't come in the flesh. The Bible records you as a deceiver and as an antichrist. Did you know that in the Bible there are more than one antichrist? I mean, when you think of antichrist, oh, you know, the 666 and the, you know, well, no. There are all kinds of antichrists as you build up to the antichrist. There are churches out there today that are antichrist with their doctrines. Now, let's turn to 1 John 2. 22. 1 John 2:22. Who is a liar? I know what you're thinking. Politicians, used car salesmen, a 5-year-old kid that just stole a cookie. Who is a liar? But he that denieth that Jesus is the Christ. All those Pharisees, Sadducees, and scribes are liars. Is it recorded, I think, at the end of John, or is it Matthew, that there's a common lie of the Jews about, you know, they came along and stole the body of Jesus, and, you know, we'll pay you money. And we'll protect you, you know? If you have somebody who says Jesus is not the Christ, they are, according to the scripture I just read to you, a liar. Do you know who the liar is? Check out John 8:44, the Gospel of John, the same writer of 2 John, the same writer of 1 John, the same writer of the Gospel of John. Go read what he said that Jesus quoted in John 8:44. I dare you to. Who is a liar but he that denieth that Jesus is the Christ? He that's a liar, that denies Jesus is the Christ, he is antichrist.
Ooh, that big 666 guy. Ooh, ooh, oh, hail Lucifer! Hail Lucifer's my God! Antichrist, I can't wait.
Go down to the Jehovah Witnesses meeting and
Antichrist guys.
They come knocking on your door.
Antichrist, that's who they are.
They deny that Jesus is the Christ. It says that denies the Father and the Son. Well, we believe that Jesus is the Son of... No, you don't, because Jesus is God. And God is Jesus. Acts 20:28. John 10:30. Let that... Where are we? Verse 23. Whosoever denieth the Son, the same has not the Father. You can't be saved. You can't say you are a Christian and you deny that Jesus is the Christ or Jesus is God or Jesus is not God and God is not Jesus. You don't have the Father. You're not saved. Whosoever denieth the Son, the same has not the Father. But he that acknowledges the Son has the Father also. Let that therefore abide in you, which you have heard from the beginning. If that which ye have heard from the beginning shall remain in you, ye also shall continue in the Son and the Father. So there were things that the apostles were saying and teaching that were to abide in you, what the doctrine of the apostles and the disciples of Christ taught. That is to remain in you. But there's another doctrine. There's another thing coming along that will be taught that is not taught after Christ, that Jesus is, you know, just a great teacher. He's not God. Couldn't be God. I mean, after all, he said to one person, why calls out me good? There's only one that's good, and that's God the Father. So he can't be God because he didn't say he was good. And you wrestle with the scriptures. Christ was virgin born. No one else was virgin born. Which means scripturally, Jesus Christ had no earthly father. There's only one other person in this world that had no earthly father. He also had no belly button. And his wife had no earthly father. And she probably had no belly button. And that would be Adam and Eve. Can you imagine the fun that Adam and Eve would look at their two children, Cain and Abel, and see that little hole in their belly? Because they didn't have one. They looked down like, where's ours? His conception was not of a male, but of the Holy Ghost. Luke 1:35. I'll trust you to go read that on your own. I'll let you go do some studying yourself. I'm not going to do all the work for you. By now, you should be able to grow in grace and want to grow and want to go search the scripture. Now, yet, Jesus was completely human. And he's completely God. I want to go. Let's go to Luke 1:35. We need to go there. We got time. Lord comes and we'll let the Lord finish this. Luke 1:35. Let's read the human and the holiness of God. And the angel appeared unto her and said, the Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, and the power of the Highest shall overshadow thee. Therefore also that holy thing shall be born of thee, which shall be born of thee, shall be called the Son of God. Completely human in the womb, as a human, but 100% God. No man. 100% God, no man, 100% man in a womb. Life comes from the Holy Spirit. Job 34:4. The virgin birth is a sign to the Jews, Isaiah 7:14. They did not believe the record of God through Jesus Christ. And they turn around in John 8:44, as they're liars, they would say that they said unto him, We be not born of fornication. They denied the Isaiah 7:14, a virgin shall conceive a child, and he shall call his name Emmanuel. They believed that Jesus was born of fornication. Why would they say it? A denial of what God said in prophecy that came to be, and rejected that 100% man and 100% God. They became an antichrist. For we are told in the Holy Scriptures that it was not a man, it was the Holy Ghost. They dismissed the sign of Isaiah's writing and God being able to do what he said. Jewish religions today do not teach that Jesus Christ was virgin born. And they do not hold to the fact that Jesus is God. They will call him a good teacher. And in fact, today the Jewish rabbis are deceivers, according to 2 John. They are antichrist. How do you test a man's state in God? Ask them who Jesus Christ is. And when they give you a mumble jumble, then come down and say, I got another question for you. Is Jesus God? And is God Jesus? Remember I said every woman gives birth to a child of heaven or a child of hell? Every child will reject Christ, or every child has the opportunity of rejecting Christ or believing on Christ. Every child will say, yes, that is God. Or every child that is born will say, no, he's a teacher or he's anything else. That's the two only answers. And that is the question of salvation. Who do you believe Jesus is? Look what Nicodemus believed in John chapter 3. Look at John, let's go there. John chapter 3. I'll show you something. The Lord just laid on my heart. Great when the word's alive. When you can teach it and God can use you, say, hey, let's go over here. Why? I don't know. Maybe God's speaking to one person. And God says, hey, go over here. John chapter 3, verse 1. There was a man of the Pharisees named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews. The same came to Jesus by night and said to him, Rabbi, we know that thou art a teacher come from God. For no man could do these miracles that thou doest except God be with him. How about, Rabbi, we know that thou art God, and no man could do these miracles that thou doest except you be God. See, he believed he was a teacher. Now, let's see, the end of the Gospel of John. This one I don't have written down, so let me try to find it here. The end of John right, John chapter 20. Now, check this one out. John chapter 20, verse 28, and read this to a Jehovah's Witness and see him blow their fuse. And Thomas the doubter, and Thomas, the one who says, you know, at least I see the print of his nails, I won't believe. And Thomas answered and said unto him, Jesus, my Lord and my God. What a difference from Nicodemus. Thomas was not a doubter anymore. Thomas is no longer a deceiver. He is no antichrist. That is my Lord and my God. Now, the rabbis lead their people astray. And what it's not funny that the religious leaders in Jesus' time claimed that Jesus was the deceiver. Matthew 27:63, John 7:12, and John 7:47, they would claim that Jesus is the deceived one. He is the deceiver of the people. And yet they would spark the whole nation of Israel and say, crucify him and give us Barabbas. You know? But yet Jesus warned the people of them, the Pharisees, the Sadducees, and the scribes, in Matthew 24, verses 4, 5, 11, and 24. He would rebuke them through the people, teaching that they were, it's a back and forth. Jesus, you're a deceiver. And Jesus would say, no, you're the deceiver. And over, he'd tell them, listen, I am. And you don't know who I am. I will go, but you can't come. And you will deny who I am, and you will teach these people who I am not. Look at what Jesus said to match John's warning on how stern a warning we have. In the tribulation period, look at Matthew 24:24. As the days grow on unto the millennium, or the seventh or final year of the tribulation, you're going to get more deceivers and you're going to get more antichrist. And until the church is raptured out of here, you're going to get deceivers and antichrists infesting the church. The church will go apostate. It won't get better. And brother, if you've been in the churches I've been in right around my neighborhood, and some of them I don't even have to walk in, I just got to read their stupid signs. He says in 24:24, for there shall arise false Christs and false prophets, and shall show great and wonders, shall show great signs and wonders, insomuch that if it were possible, they should deceive the very elect Jews. We ain't done. Just because we have one religious group that says that Jesus is not God, we're not done. And do you realize those people have a worldwide ministry far reaches what the Bible-believing Christian gets? And we haven't even crossed the Mississippi to get over to the Salt Lake City, who has another Jesus, who did not ascend into heaven in Acts chapter 1, but went to North America. Find that in the Bible. And they'll give you things. Again, for there shall rise false Christs and false prophets, and shall show great signs and wonders. Sounds like a serpent. Insomuch that, if it were possible, they should deceive the very elect. Jesus warns like John did. Take heed that no man deceive you. If that's a warning by Jesus, then there is the capability that you and I can be deceived. Adam and Eve were in a perfect state of sinlessness, great fellowship with God, and yet they were still. The Bible records that Eve was deceived. So don't think, Mama, if you take your child and put him into a Christian college, he'll be shielded and protected from Satan, and no, that's the worst place to send your child. Especially if they don't have a King James Bible and teach against it. I have seen men sent into colleges and come out as possums. You find them dead on the road. Dead to serving God. Dead to the belief in God. Deaf to the faith of God. John heard these very words of Jesus Christ. Lastly, Jesus. For many shall come in my name. Many! Saying, I am Christ.
Well, there's a guy over here who says he's Jesus.
You know how many Mexican men are called Jesus? That would be many, wouldn't it?
Well, this guy over here in Texas, he proclaims to be the Messiah.
For many shall come in my name, saying, I am Christ, and shall deceive many. The Bible says, few will get saved, many will be deceived, many will go into the broad way. Don't be shocked when the news headlines say,
oh, here we are over here in this Christian group. They proclaim to have Jesus as their group, and you know, they drank some milk or something, and now they're all dead.
Hey! Jesus already told you! And Mr. Media, radio, and television news, they are not Christians! They are deceivers and antichrists. Read your Bible! Don't you call that church over there in Rome a Christian church? They deny Jesus Christ and give Mary the attributes. They are a deceiver and an antichrist. Don't you reference them to me. You are liars when you do that. Read Fox's Book of Mormon and find out what the Christians, that church is. There will be many deceivers, and many will be deceived from the mouth of Jesus and John, the beloved disciple. Don't be shocked.
Oh, there's this religious sect over here, and they're following.
I just read today some woman proclaimed that she's got the baby Jesus in her womb.
We're in the end times. Jesus is.
No! I know we're in the end times, but no! Jesus already said. It's going to happen. Rest assured that, hey, I'm waiting for Jesus Christ as much as you are, but rest assured when somebody says they're Jesus, when someone says they're the Christ, hey, amen, the Bible already said it, the Bible is true. When somebody cusses me out in the street for preaching the gospel or giving the gospel to, hey, you told me, all they that live godly in Christ Jesus shall suffer persecution. You just made the Bible more real to me. Thank you. Have a good day. In Luke 2:7, Jesus is born. Again, he is born all man and all God. How explain that? I have no idea. I can't even picture Mary and have to change God's diaper. It says in Luke chapter 2 or 3, I believe it's, after he was 12 years old and, you know, he was left behind. The movie series, Left Behind. Jesus was left behind. DCF calls on the parents. Huh? Do you know it says that Jesus was subject to Mary and Joseph? God. Now Jesus, go over there and do the dishes. Jesus could have broke those dishes up and said, let there be new dishes. I mean, he did it in Genesis 1. Jesus, it's time for your bed. Jesus could say, hey, I don't want to go to bed and have to, son, remember Joshua? Come up and stay so I don't have to go to bed. He could have done that, but he didn't. He is born without sin. Luke 2:21. He is named Jesus. He is prophesied to Simon, verses 26 and 29. According to the Holy Ghost, fulfilled. The conceivement, the birth, the life, and the death of Jesus Christ are an established scriptural fact. What the prophets foresaw, the Holy Spirit fulfilled in Jesus. Matter of fact, Paul says the gospel is that Christ died for our sins and was buried according to Scripture and arose again the third day according to Scripture. John 10:30, which I lay on every Jehovah Witness, Jesus proclaimed, he is God. And then when you read that to a Jehovah Witness, it brings an attack and a defense. And this verse proclaims what they do not believe. Jesus is God. Try it. Oh, you believe that verse? Oh, I've seen them flip their wigs. I think it's funny. I called one time for a Bible when I was dealing with a Jehovah's Witness. I mean, she went up and grabbed their paperwork out of my hand and took off. Try it. John 10:30. It's easy verse. I and the Father are one. That's simple. The words of Jesus, John 10:32, produces the Jews to collect stones and to charge them with blasphemy. What has happened here is a Jewish Old Testament capital punishment of stoning. The Jews distinguish full well, that what Jesus said. They knew full well what he declared, that he is not a God, but the God. The stoning was a doctrinal truth to the words of Christ. He proclaimed to be God. Now, Acts 20:28, what does it say? Take heed therefore unto yourselves, and to all the flock over to which the Holy Ghost has made you overseers, to feed the church of God, which he has purchased with his own blood. Now examine the verse. There is God the Father. There is also the Holy Ghost, two-thirds of the Holy Trinity. Now examine the following scriptures. Hebrews 10:19, 12:20, and 9:12, 1 Peter 1:2, Revelation 1:5, 1 John 1:7, Ephesians 2:13, just to name a few. Now I'll go leave you to go look those up. What does the verse in Acts 20:28 say? It says, God purchased the church with his own blood. That scripture with scripture that I just gave you, Jesus Christ shed his blood, That blood of Acts 20:28 is God's blood. So Acts 20:28 and the verses I gave you above shows that God and Jesus' blood are the same. So God and Jesus are the same. It is a fact that God and Jesus Christ are one by blood. Acts 20:28 says it was God that died on the cross, that God is Jesus Christ, and Jesus said he is God. You can't get around it unless you're deceived. 2 John 7 is telling a bold certainly. We don't need Webster's here. A deceiver is one who confesses not that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh. The denial that Jesus Christ is God. Oh, many may say Jesus was real, but he was a teacher, a man of God. Some do deny the existence of Jesus. Some deny that he was who he was, God. You can say, okay, he's nobody. You can say he's a teacher, or you can say he is God. That is the scope of what John's talking about here. Yes, there are some that will say there's no Jesus. And then there are some say there was a Jesus. And then number three, Jesus is God. Number three, Jesus is God is the correct answer. And that's the only answer for someone to proclaim that they are saved. You can't be saved if, oh, there's no Jesus. Sorry. You can't be saved. Jesus is not God. He was a teacher. You can't be saved. The Muhammad believes Jesus was real and alive. And the Koran even speaks of Jesus. 25 times Jesus is mentioned. But they do not believe he is God. They're not saved. Muslims respect and revere Jesus. Peace be upon him. They consider him one of the greatest of God's messengers to mankind, but not God. The Koran approves his virgin birth, where the rabbis don't. And a chapter of Koran is entitled Maryam. Capital M-A-R-Y-A-M, which would be Mary. Jesus was born miraculously by a command of God. This is in the Koran. The same command that had brought Adam into being with neither a father nor a mother. That's an interesting statement. The same command that God said, let us make man, said, let us make Jesus. Muslims believe that Jesus was not crucified. They can't be saved. That's not the gospel. That Christ died for our sins. He had to die. It was the plan of Jesus' enemies to crucify him, but God saved him and raised him up to him. Well, that's not in the Gospels. I'm sorry. Christ died and was buried and arose from the grave according to Scripture. That's where we got to depart with the Muslims. And that's where we got to tell the Muslims, I'm sorry, but you're wrong. The Bible says he died on that cross. The Bible says he spoke to the dying thief. The Bible says they buried him. The Bible says he arose the third day. And the likeness of Jesus was put over another man. Can't believe that. That's not true. That's an antichrist. That's a deceiver. They have taken the story of Jesus and they have deceived it with another story. Jesus' enemies took this man and crucified him, thinking that he was Jesus, and that's wrong. Now, that statement there of a false gospel is a deceiver. Here's a man that proclaims to be Jesus or thought to be Jesus who died. You see what I mean? Here's another Jesus. And here are people who are deceived by this story that is found in their holy book, the Koran. Muslims believe that Jesus was a messenger of God. That's good. I know Jesus was a messenger of God. Matter of fact, Jesus is a messenger that is God. They do not attribute any divinity to him, as he was just a merely a human being. Well, according to 2 John, let me read it. Let me go to it and read it. According to 2 John, verse 7, for many deceivers are entered into the world, and there's many Muslims, who confess not that Jesus Christ has come in the flesh. This is a deceiver antichrist. Well, they say he's not God, so that's a deceiver. Yes, they say he came in the flesh. But how many babies have been born in this world that's come in the flesh? Since Cain and Abel. But they're not God. The Koran states, O people of the book, commit no excuses in your religion, nor say of Allah aught be true. Christ Jesus, the Son of Mary, was no more than a messenger of Allah, and his word which he bestowed on Mary and a spirit proceeding from him. So believe in Allah and his apostles. Say not Trinity, deist. It will be better for you, for Allah is one Allah. Glory be to him, for extolled is he above having a son. To him belonging all things in the heaven and the earth. And enough is Allah as a disposer of affairs. That's Koran 4:171. So according to 2 John 7, the Islam, the Koran religion is a deceiver and antichrist. As you read above, they completely reject the gospel. For Christ died on the cross. According to scripture, he was buried, according to scriptures, and arose. Jesus did that what the scriptures told of. Jesus, who is the word, fulfilled the word and lived the word totally, John 1:1. That Koran 4:171 violates 2 John 7 for salvation. So if you believe what Jesus of the Koran is, you can't say you're going to heaven. You can't say you're not a Christian. Now, if you read the Koran and say that Jesus died for your sins, he died upon the cross, and they buried him, and he arose from the grave, and he was virgin born, and he is the only one that can pay for your sins, and you read the Koran, you are just as saved as I am. You can believe that Jesus died for your sins according to the gospel, and put your faith and trust in him, and that nothing else can save you from your sins, and go to your church and eat and drink his body and blood, and you can be saved as I am. You're just doing it wrong. Let's look at Hebrews 11:6. But without faith, it is impossible to believe him. Excuse me, we'll try it again. But without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is God, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. The first step in salvation is you must believe in God. You can't be saved and be an atheist. You can't be saved and believe in another God. You got to believe in the God of the Bible. No one can declare to be an atheist or an agnostic and say they are saved. You have to believe there is a God to save you. And with conjunction of 2 John 7, let us move to Hebrews 11, 6, up a notch. Jesus Christ is God is a scriptural fact that I will not argue. And if you do not believe that fact, you are the one that's in error and the scriptures are right. Jesus is God, and according to Hebrews 11, 6, can you be saved in belief or what is written is in the Koran 4:171 that states that Jesus is not God? The answer is no. Hebrews 11:6 and Koran 4:171 are complete opposite of each other. You must come to God. You must believe that He is. John 8:24 and Exodus 22:3. I am. Jesus proclaims again, He is God. And being God, He is the way. For I am the way, the truth, and the life. And no man cometh unto the Father but by me. Salvation requires an essential belief that Jesus Christ is God. So in the light of Hebrews 11:6, if you do not believe Jesus is God, you cannot come to God. Coming to God is coming to Jesus. Coming to Jesus is coming to God. It is impossible to be right with God. It is impossible to be right with God. It is impossible to be right with God with unbelief. Hebrews 11:6. Islam, Jews, Jehovah's Witnesses, atheists, Unitarians, most of your Eastern religions, according to 2 John 7, if Jesus Christ is taught that He is not God and did not come in the flesh, they are deceivers and antichrists. And I did not make that declaration. I have quoted and printed it for you. And you can get a copy of this book. I can send you the link. I can send it to you. You can read it and print it out. You can send this copy to Staples where I had it, sent it to them and had them print it. There's a lot of errors in it though. That's why I'm having trouble reading. As the Bible says, ye must be born again. It also has many other musts. You must believe Jesus is God. Not even 5 minutes will tell you if someone is truly saved. Do they believe Jesus is God? If not, they are not saved. That's a bold statement. But the Bible made that statement. The Bible can make that statement. I can say, because my particular liking, Dr. Pepper is the soda of all sodas. You can fight me on that. You can tell me Coca-Cola. You can tell me Pepsi, you can tell me root beer, whatever it is. And that's our opinions. That's not a scriptural fact. But when the Bible states, when God tells us, when the Holy Spirit explains it to us, and Jesus proclaims, Jesus is God and God is Jesus, no matter what kind of book that you write that you call holy, if it does not proclaim that Jesus is God, it is a lie. It is a deceiver. It is an antichrist book. And you get mad with me however you want, but get mad at God because He's the one that wrote it. And I'll settle it with God. The fact is that He is God and Jesus is God and I'm saved. So when you deal with somebody and they say they are a Christian, and you really want to find out where do they stand, ask them, do you believe Jesus is God? And there's only two answers they can give. You got to make them say yes or no. Don't. Oh, he was a one. I think he was a one. I don't care what you think. Is he God? Well, I believe. No. The question is yes or no. Be firm. Be strict. Do you believe Jesus is God? Yes or no? If the answer is no, they're not saved. Because he has to be God to save you. If he's not God, he's just any common Joe or Reuben, since he was Jewish. And no common Jewish person, Reuben, Judah, or whatever name you can get from a Jewish family, that person is not going to save you. It has to be the man that is God and the God that is man. That's it. That's all there is. There is no argument. God said it.